Hey everybody, I'm Pastor Benjamin.
And I'm Harrison.
And we are so excited to see you today. And we cannot wait for today's lesson. But before we get started, we are going to praise God together. So come on, let's get up on our feet and let's do it. Everybody, welcome to the city. It's so nice to see you. I love living in the city. There's something here for everybody.
Yes.
I mean, there's movies and theaters and skate parks and dog parks.
Yes.
I mean, there's no other place in the world where you can get a donut covered with your favorite cereal and then go right up the block and get your favorite superhero autograph right there for you.
Wow. Everybody in the city has got somewhere to go. and there's no shortage of transportation. But what's crazy is that most people here don't even own cars.
Whew, wow.
They walk, ride the subway, yeah. Take a taxi, or even the bus. That's what I do. But the bus I ride isn't just an ordinary bus.
Oh, no.
No way. This bus is full of fun, and here it comes now.
Come on. Yes, today's game is City Trivia.
Yes.
So, we're going to read a question to you all, and if you think you know what the answer is, just shout it out. So, who's ready to play? So, the first question is, how many taxis are in New York City? Is it 22,956, 188, 1 million,
wow.
Or 13,587? What do you guys think it is? A, B, C, or D?
Okay, let's see the answer. It's 13,587.
Whoa.
That's a lot of taxis.
Yes.
Whoa, talk about a traffic jam. All right, let's go to our next question up there. In what city will you find the most visited museum in America?
Whoa.
A, Washington, D.C., B, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, C, New York, New York, or D, Chicago, Illinois? So is it A, B, C, or D?
Okay, let's see what the answer is. The answer to this one is Washington, D.C. There are many museums in that city, and they're all free. I mean, who, if it's free, it's for me. I mean, am I right or am I right?
You're right.
All right, the most visited city of all the museums is in D.C., which is the Smithsonian National Air and Space Museum. There you can go see planes, spacecrafts, astronaut gear,
wow.
And so much more. How cool is that?
That's really dope.
Okay, ready for our last trivia question? Here we go. There are 182 cities in America with this word in their name. What word is it? Is it A, pickle, B, Christmas, C, little, or D, chickens? Chickens, wow, okay. A, B, C, or D?
Okay, let's see what the answer is. The answer is Christmas. There are exactly 182 cities in the US who have named themselves after America's favorite holiday, Christmas.
Wow.
If you guessed that, good job. But if you didn't get a chance to answer today, no worries, you'll get another chance.
City life is just the best, and not just because there are a million things to see and do. What really makes the difference is the people who live here.
Yes.
I mean, there are people who like to eat steak, others who like to eat sushi, people who work in tall buildings and those who work in the subway underground. Some people like listening to techno while others enjoy K-pop. I mean, really, when I think about it, my favorite thing about the city is the everyday people who make it up.
Yeah, and one of my favorite of those people is our city award-winning reporter, Joe Miller. She goes out into the streets to find some really great people who bring this city to life.
Oh, hey.
It looks like it's the time now, so let's tune in.
It's Joe on the Go, and I'm Joe Miller, coming to you live each and every day as I take to the streets to give you all the deets. You know, we've been talking a lot about how everyday people in this awesome city of ours use the armor of God in amazing ways. Well, my friends, today is no exception. We are about to meet one of my faves. His name is Coach. I mean, that's what we call him. I'm like totally sure that's not what is on his birth certificate, but he goes by Coach. And I can't wait for you to meet him. Hey Coach, think fast.
Whoa, Joe, nice kick. I think I'm ready to put you on the field. Defense or offense?
Oh, I'm not so sure about that, but if you need a sub, I will do what I can. Okay, Coach, for reals, let's get right into it and talk stats. Now, you've led your team to 8 regional championships, 5 State Cup victories, and 10 of your players have gone on to play pro. Oh, and it doesn't stop there. I've also read that as a coach, you have won 2 Golden Net Awards. FYI, that award goes to the coach who is voted like the best of the very best. Coach, you are basically an all-star. How do you do it? The love of the game, a special coaching technique?
Well, Joe, I do love the game of soccer, and coaching a great team is the best. But winning those games and awards isn't everything. It's more about developing the players.
Oh, don't you worry. I did my research. All I had to do was Google best soccer moves. So when you say developing the players, you mean things like perfecting their bicycle kicks, juggling, and headers? You know, kind of like that guy.
Now that is some fancy footwork. My players do work hard on the field each and every day. But really, at the end of the game, I want players who share the good news of God's love on and off the field.
That sounds like you were talking about a certain piece of God's armor right there.
Yes, of course, the good news boots.
Ding, ding, ding. Tell us more.
I knew that in order for my players to see what this looked like, I had to put on the good news boots first. That meant having the courage to share God's love with them. As their coach, they could follow my lead and have the courage to do the same.
Well, that is a great way to coach, Coach. Tell us, what does it look like for your team to put on the good news boots?
That's a great question. We decided to start doing things off the field to show God's love to other people.
Oh, wow, I like that game plan. Well, what kind of stuff did your team do?
We started helping the younger teams with their drills and skills, and while we were doing that, we were sharing the good news that God loves them. We also started praying with them before each game. That's a great way to put God at the center of what we do. The team also started volunteering together once a month, helping prepare a meal for those who might not have one. The really cool thing about all of this is that a lot of the players on our team initially had to build up the courage to share the good news. But by the end of the season, they had the confidence to share God's love with everyone. They all started as rookies and ended as pros.
Coach, that is so great. Hey, thanks for kicking it with us today and showing us how the good news boots can work in action. I am so glad your team had the courage to share with others about how much God loves them. That really helps all of us remember that we can share the good news with others too.
You sure can. It could be on your own sports team, in your school, neighborhood, or really anywhere. The good news boots will help you wherever you go.
Well, that's it for us today. Join us next time for Joe on the Go. I can't wait to see who we will meet next.
That was amazing. I love finding more and more about the people who use their everyday armor to make this city super special.
Yeah.
Coach's story encourages me that anyone can take the good news of God's love wherever they go.
Yeah.
To help us think about what we just heard, we're going to ask you guys some questions.
Okay, our first question is about the piece of God's armor that Coach just told us about. Who remembers what that piece is called?
That's right. He told us about the good news boots and how they give him and his players the courage to tell people the good news that God loves them.
Yeah.
Was it always easy for the players to share the good news of God's love with others?
No, it wasn't. But that's why God gives us the good news boots. He knew that we would need his power to have the courage to share his love with others. And the more that they did it, the easier it got. What are some things that Coach and the team did to show God's love to others?
Yes, when we show God's love to other people, we're also telling them the good news about him. But what is the good news of God's love? Let me show you.
Guess what? God loves you and wants to be your friend. John 3:16 says, God loved the people of this world so much that he gave his only son, so that everyone who has faith in him will have eternal life and never really die. You can't be friends with God because of your sin. Ecclesiastes 7:20 says, not a single person on earth is always good and never sins. What is sin? Sin is doing or thinking something that God says is wrong. God made a way for you to be his friend. He sent Jesus from heaven to earth to take the punishment for all of your sin. Just knowing about Jesus is not enough to fix your friendship with God. You need to admit you have done wrong things and you are truly sorry. Believe in your heart that Jesus died for you and that God brought him back to life. And commit to following Jesus as the leader and Lord of your life forever.
So that's what God's love is all about.
Yeah.
When we decide to follow Jesus, God makes us a part of his army and gives us all of his powerful armor. One piece of that armor is the good news boots that we're talking about today. With the good news boots on, we'll have the courage to tell others what we believe about Jesus.
Yeah.
And we will be ready to share that this good news is for them too.
Each piece of God's armor is completely invisible, but that doesn't mean it's not real.
Exactly.
Even though we can't see God's armor, when we put it on every single day, it'll make us strong and give us God's power. I've got a symbol for each piece of God's armor that will help you remember what it's for.
There are six pieces. The first piece is the armor that God has given us, which is the belt of truth. Then there's the armor of godliness and the good news boots, which we're talking about today.
Yes.
We need the shield of faith, the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit too. When we put on the full armor of God, we'll be able to stand strong against any evil that comes our way.
Yes.
We meet so many people every single day who need to know the good news that God loves them. That's why it's so important for us to put on the full armor of God every day and the good news boots. That's exactly what we're learning today. Everyone stand up and let's say this together.
Say this after me. Put on.
Put on.
The good news boots.
The good news boots.
Put on.
Put on.
The good news boots.
The good news boots. You got it. We all need the armor of God because everyone needs to hear the good news and how much God loves them.
Yeah.
Here, check out this Bible story about why it's so important to wear the good news boots.
You would think that sharing good news would be really easy, but there's a spiritual battle taking place between God and the devil over the hearts of each person on earth. God is fighting for people to know who he is and how much he loves them. But the devil, his enemy, is evil and will do anything to keep people from hearing the good news about God's love. So God gave us a piece of his armor called the good news boots. They give us the courage to go and tell the good news, just like Jesus taught his disciples to do. 3 days after Jesus died, God brought him back to life. Jesus appeared to his disciples on a mountainside near Galilee, and when they saw him, they worshiped him and thanked God for his love. Jesus had an important message he wanted them to understand. Jesus said, "Go and make followers of all the people in the world. Teach them to obey everything I have told you to do, and you can be sure that I will be with you always." The disciples knew that sharing the good news of God's love might be hard, but they did what Jesus asked them to do. When we decide to follow Jesus, we should tell the people around us the good news about him. It can be easy to make excuses like, "People might make fun of me," "I don't know what to say," or "It's too hard." But with the good news boots, God gives us the right words to say and helps us to not be afraid. Jesus' promise to the disciples is true for us too. He will always be with us. When we wear the good news boots, telling other people about God's love has the power to change their lives forever. We can put on the good news boots.
That story is so important because it helps us to understand that it won't always be easy to tell others the good news of God's love, but it also helps us to see that people won't know the good news if we don't tell them and show them.
Exactly. The boots in God's armor gives us the courage to share the good news of his love with everyone.
Yep.
People who live next door, people who live far away, and even people who can be hard to get along with. When we wear the good news boots and trust Jesus, we know that we can share God's love with the world.
Now, you may be wondering, what does it look like to put on God's armor in real life? Well, I have an example of someone who has. Here, meet Max.
Max is a kid, just like you. Max tries his best to put on each piece of God's armor every day. He's been nervous to talk to his friend Liam about God's love because Liam's family doesn't believe in God. But with the good news boots on, Max is able to tell Liam about how much God loves him. Just like Max, you can put on the good news boots and tell everyone you know about God's love.
When we put on his full armor on, the enemy doesn't stand a chance. Okay, now we're going to put on God's armor together. Here, check this out.
Every day, I will wear the full armor of God. I put on the belt of truth so I can fight the devil's lies. I put on the armor of godliness to protect my heart and do what's right. I put on the good news boots so I'll be ready to show God's love all day. I hold up the shield of faith to block anything the enemy sends my way. I put on the helmet of salvation so I'll remember God will always love me. I use the sword of the Spirit because God's word is my best weapon against the enemy. Now, I stand firm and pray.
Great, we're all armored up. Now, to practice putting on some boots, I want to play a game. Today, we're going to play Who's Boots?
Okay, now I'm gonna put a picture up on the screen of some boots. When you think you know who they belong to, shout it out and you could be a winner. Let's play. Let's get our first picture up there.
All right, who do you think these boots belong to? Those are great guesses. Let's see who in the city wears these kicks.
Firefighter. That was an easy one, but let's try another one that might be a little tougher. Ready? Here we go. Okay, whose boots are these? Okay, those are some pretty good guesses. Let's see who these boots actually belong to.
It was a nurse. Okay, we have one more set of boots to look at. Remember, whoever answers the fastest and correctly will get the point. This one is going to be really tough, but I think we can handle it. Here we go. Let's see those boots. Those are some cool boots. Who do they belong to?
Okay. Let's see what the answer is. Wow, that was a tough one, but it was a construction worker.
Wow.
Yeah, I know, right? Who would have thunk? No matter what shoes we wear, when we put on the good news boots, we'll take the good news of God's love through everyone we meet. All throughout the Bible, we see people using prayer and worship as a weapon to defend themselves against the enemy. That's because when we pray and when we worship God, we're declaring that God is more powerful than anything and anyone else who would try to harm us. And that's what we're going to declare right now.
Dear God, thank you for giving us your full armor. Help us to remember to put on each and every piece so that we can stand firm against the devil's lies and tricks. We know that you are greater than anything that we face, and we love you. Amen.
Amen.
Remember, we've got God's power with us, and we're ready to face anything the evil one would ever throw our way.
All right, boys and girls, this has been a fantastic day, and I've learned a whole lot. What was your favorite part about today?
Personally, I loved the Good News Boots story.
I would agree with you. It is so encouraging to know that God has given us armor and a gift to share the good news with other people. We can be courageous even in times where we might be a little afraid. Okay, boys and girls, this has been a fantastic day, but we have to go. Besides, Harrison and I have a plan with a basketball, a ladder, a can of Coke, and some elf shoes. Okay? All right, we'll see you guys later.
Later.